Hey, my name is Shailen Dawkins, I just want to say, like, it's such an honor to meet you.
Thank you, sir.
I'm 19 years old, so just as a young kid, you know what I'm saying? Like, and
I've got 19-year-old shoelaces.
Like, what does success look like to you?
It looks like I have to stay humble and normal. Mm-hmm. Keep my receptors open for inspiration. And I get to be a humble servant of a power that I call God. It's been that way all my life, but that's the best way I've found it to do it. And it makes me enjoy my life, whether I'm working or not. And I get the chance to take time for my sons and my grandchildren and my animals. And that's where happiness is for me.
I kind of wanted to backtrack a little bit and ask you about early in your career. I wanted to mm-hmm. ask what felt like your breakthrough career moment. So maybe what was the role or what did you work on that felt like, okay, this is a breakthrough?
Well, I came from a society right after the Depression where everybody was broke and everybody was poor. And there's some people who ran away from the blacklist. They were called communists, but they really were not. They were socialists. And they created the unions in the United States. And out of there came people like actors by the name of John Garfield, and Tallulah Bankhead, and Dalton Trumbo, who won an Oscar. And there was a black actor by the name of Kennedy Lee. And there was a film called Lifeboat. You can look it up and see what's happening. They ran from a blacklist scourge around America. It was Senator Estes Kefauver was his name, out of Tennessee. And they ran to a sympathetic Board of Education district in New York City. They put those intellectual cream of the crop people, sent them to Brooklyn. And as a result, I grew up with their children. And because of that, I grew up with a composite and a diverse bunch of people. So if my parents didn't get home at time, I didn't come from a black neighborhood. I came from a poor one. There's a difference. So if I didn't get home in time for dinner, I had a choice. I could go around, I could smell my way around the world. I'd go upstairs and get some filter fish or around the corner and get some lasagna or get some corned beef and cabbage. Depends on who was home, and they could do the same thing with us. So I was raised very diversely right after the Depression to rely on one another. We had broomstick handles instead of bats, and we weren't sophisticated at all. So we paid attention, our imaginations got very vivid. So the Hopalong Cassidy and the Roy Rogers and Superman and Batman were kind of real to us. And I got to that age, about the 12 or 13, where I did not look like Superman. Racially, I started to get problems, and they asked me what was the problem. I said, I didn't look like Superman. They said, stop that. You're Superman today. So I grew up past 21, 22 years old, as an equal black man, which is very rare in America, as a result of the Depression. So what had happened, and that English teacher said, you should go down and try out for this lead in this Broadway play because you got something in you. I didn't know what he was talking about. It was natural to me. And I got the part, never having acted before in my life. It was a lead on Broadway. So that's lightning in a bottle. So they got me. It was autobiographical with Lewis Peterson was the writer. And he was married to Peggy Fury, who was Lee Strasberg's teacher. So I went right into that society, those serious acting societies, the Actor's Studio, John Stix, Maureen Stapleton, all of them were quite serious. And I got they inherited me, and it got into my bloodstream quite quickly. They treated life differently. So I had a head start on most of my contemporaries, black or white. So mm-hmm. in 1953, just before Labor Day, I opened in the lead in the Broadway show, never having studied before as an actor. The Broadway show called Take a Giant Step. The rest is history.
In your eyes, like, why do you think things like television, why do you think like movies and stuff is so important? Nowadays, something like representation is very important. So I kind of want to ask, like, in terms of film and television, like, why is it so important? Or why do you think film and television is so important?
Well, any device that can creatively get in touch with your audience is extremely important. There's Marshall McLuhan. I don't know if you remember him in your studies. Marshall McLuhan. And the name of his book is called The Medium is the Message. And anything that can get to you through television, film, iPod, anything that can get to you is extremely important. I'll give you an example. 1959, 1960, I believe it was. And I went to Africa and was in a play called, in a movie called The Bush Baby. It's a small animal, and I'm playing a boy from Africa. And I had just finished an episode of The Nurses in New York, where I played a juvenile delinquent and got shot in the stomach. And the cops were trying to catch me, and I got these stitches in my stomach. And I ran, and the stitches break, and I died. That's the episode. So now, fade out, fade in, I'm getting off of Nairobi Airport, and this is the first year of national television in Africa, in Kenya. The president is Jomo Kenyatta and his wife, and people are looking in storefronts, looking at their first televisions. Because I get off the plane, these kids look at me, and they go crazy. Their eyes get big, and I don't know enough Swahili. But they go, they follow me all the way to the hotel. Finally, a brave young man says, could you do me a favor? And I said, what? Is could you take off your shirt? So I took off my shirt and they went bananas. Hey, So then they said to me, he says, what, how did you do that? I said, how did you do that? How did you come back to life? Hmm. That's the influence of the screens on the people of the world.
And I kind of wanted to ask as well, as you were coming up, like, was there a piece of advice that you were given that still stuck with you? I know you touched on it a little earlier when you're talking about mentors or people that supported you, but I wanted to ask specifically if there was like one piece of advice that you've been given that's really been beneficial.
Well, to all people, especially young people, there really is no such thing as impossible. If we add that word into our dictionary, we would not grow. It's just impossible to go 10 more feet. It's impossible to jump higher. It's impossible to remember that many lines. It's impossible to walk 100 miles, it's impossible. And never get to that, break that line. But take the word impossible and the action out of it. There's no such thing we cannot do.
But I just, like, for me personally, like, I just wanted to say, you know, thank you so much for everything you've done, like, just in your career. And it's been super inspiring. And, it encourages me and inspires me to, you know, keep pursuing my career and what I want to do. So I just wanted to
thank you. I wish you luck. Hope to see you down the road.
Thank you. I hope to be there, man. I hope to be there.
Thank you for your time, brother. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you.